I have officially returned to the clan that I created about 3 years ago. In today's episode, we're going to talk about clan development and rebuilding a clan. Stay tuned. Hey, what's going on, guys? Joe here, coming at you today from Clan Paradox. It's been about a year since I've been over here, and today's topic is how to build a clan or how to rebuild a clan. And that's kind of what we're doing here. We're going to have to get in here and get our sleeves rolled up and get to work because there's a lot of building to do. And where do you start? That's the question here. And let's go ahead and start by doing that. This is the clan, and the clan itself is about 5 or 6 years old. And I know for some of you, you're watching this video and you're like, well, of course it's going to be easy for a YouTuber to build a clan. You know, and you're possibly right. However, there are some tips and tricks, the kind of things that you can do, or things or avenues or approaches or things that you could do in order to build a clan. And obviously, you know, be catchy with the name. You know, Paradox is one of those, it doesn't make any sense. That was the point. That's what I named it. Doesn't make sense. And that's why it's a Paradox. It never makes any sense to create a new clan. And obviously your clan description needs to be a little catchy. And a lot of players out there now are seeking higher level clans, and that makes sense. They're looking for the perks and stuff like that. So creating a new clan is difficult. And where do you start when you create a new clan? Is you have to have a core group of people. You have to have people that you know, friends or family or people that you work with or whatever, that you can bring together and build that core group of people. Paradox has that core group of people in, you know, PK and Keys and FC and a couple of other guys that have been here for a really, really long time. For the most part, the clan, it's been doing very well. They were doing league type material. However, burnout is real, you know, and the game is such an old game. It's been around for a very long time. And you just don't, if you do the same thing over and over and over again, people get kind of burnt out with that, and they need, you know, a new change of pace. This topic's come up multiple times in streams. We've talked about how to build a clan or how to lead a clan and stuff like that. So it really, number one, it starts out with, you know, building that core group of people. And there's really no set number for doing that. The core group has to have a common goal. Like, what do you want to strive as a clan? And that really kind of leads us into our next topic of identify what type of clan you want to be. You know, do you want to be a ESL tribe gaming Team Queso type of clan, or do you want to work in the, you know, Champions War League or the No Dip Leagues or the MLCW or whatever other leagues are out there? And there's various leagues that you can be involved in if you're interested in that type of gameplay. But that is heavy war. You know, do you want to be a casual war clan? Do you want to build a clan that just spins war back to back to back to back? Or do you just want to do something small with your family and friends? It's just, it's really a matter of identification. There's also pushing clans out there, that let's not forget about those. And then you also have the farm league clans. So there's, you know, there's all kinds of different avenues of approaches you can do when it comes to making a clan. How do you want to go about doing that? And your core group of people have to identify that before you can really proceed with that. I mean, anybody can create a clan at 40,000 gold and name it whatever and go into global and just kind of spam free co-lead. You remember hashtags free co-lead, you know? But what you do with that beyond that is really up to you. And you as a team, or you as a core group of players, have to identify what you want to be, what you're willing to build, and how you're going to go about doing that. And then that also kind of leads us into recruiting. So recruiting, you know, you guys got the global chats, and this is one of the hardest ways to recruit right here. I've seen videos on YouTube on building a clan, and it's, you know, spamming in global, and that's so unrealistic. You know, nobody really goes in global and sees a clan spamming new clan and they want to jump right on that immediately. It's just not realistic at all. Obviously, this is a tool for recruiting, and you might be able to find some decent players, and they're like-minded players like yourself out there that want to join you through this avenue of approach. But let's go ahead and take a look at something else that you could possibly use in order to recruit. Okay, so outside of the game, there are other options that you can use in order to find clan mates or find a clan. This is is so much more. There's so much more depth that you might not know about. It's something you need to look into, is the forumsupercell.com. So this is a site that's been around for a really long time. Most people are aware of it. But if you're not, here it is. And they have other options for the other games as well. Boom Beach, Brawl Stars, and stuff like that. And they go outside to subreddits. However, this one in Clash of Clans is more in-depth. It's more detailed. And it is goes really deep. It goes, you know, you got general section, you got clan talk, and you have content creation. I have a page on content creation. I've been posting there for a really long time, for as long as I've been actively posting. However, you have clan talk. So let's go ahead and check out clan talk. And you'll notice up here in the upper right hand corner, you're looking for clanmates. And I discovered this about a month ago, and it was actually quite interesting that people post every single day, basically boosting their posts back up to the top of the list, trying to advertise their clan. And this is just something to look, you know, into if you're trying to get your clan out there, or you're trying to find a clan. That's something that, you know, some people are really trying to find home, you know, for them. And in this situation here, we got people that have been, you know, clans that have been posting for a really long time, and we want to, you know, kind of show off what they got, and a little bit of free advertisement, so to speak. You know, I'm an ELE kind of guy. Everybody love everybody. So I want to make sure that everybody gets a little bit of love here. Obviously, I can't go through all 3,000 pages or 1,000 pages here, but you know, this is an option that you could use. Now, we're going to go ahead from here and take a look at Discord. There are so many different communication pieces out there that are outside of the game that are available to you. We're just going to go ahead and take a look at one source, and then we'll talk about the other sources. Okay, so communication in the game is important. Activity in the game is extremely important, and then also there's activity outside of the game that a lot of people don't know about, and it's something that I learned, I would say, about 2015. This was a completely new world that I didn't even know existed, and it really started in the Line application. I'm sure some of you know what Line is, and there's also WhatsApp, and there is Kick, and there's some folks use Facebook Messenger, stuff like that. There's other messaging applications that are used. This one right here is Discord. This is actually my server. You can go down in the description below and join if you'd like. We have all kinds of options here. We have game chat for Brawl Stars, you know, Clash Royale, and then there's also recruiting server and stuff like that. There's a recruitment server like in here somewhere. Let me see. Yeah, clan recruitments. You can see people post their clans is here as well. And anyways, back on topic though. So you can get involved in other servers, and you can see on the sidebar over here, I'm in a bunch of different servers, Indian Legends and House of L and the TFC server. And it just goes on and on and on. Elite Academy, NDL, the No Dip League, T2. And there's just a bunch of them. You got to get out there. If you're trying to build a clan, you got to get out there and kind of meet the community. There's the community is so deep that I don't even know the full extent of it. However, you got to find like-minded individuals like yourself and your clan and get them involved. And that way you will be able to find more success in building your clan, one, as well as, you know, making it more fun, making the game more fun, you know, getting a little bit more than just a random clan war spin, but you can also face off against other larger clans and learn and go friendly challenge with them and stuff like that. So communication is key when it comes to building a clan, and you know, as long as you're communicating with your core group, but also getting out there in the community and learning faces and meeting new people, this is a great tool to use in order to do so. All right, so we've talked about, you know, that core group, who, you know, who are you as a clan? And that's what I want to hear from you guys, is who are you as a clan? Go down in the comments below and let's hear about your clan. You know, make sure you drop that clan tag so we can check you out. And if you don't know what I'm talking about when I say clan tag, we're talking about this little guy right here. Ours is 802, or hashtag 802 UV2C. And I remember that because I don't even need to look at it at this point. I know it by heart. That's how ridiculous or how old this clan is and how long I was in it. However, that, you know, enough of Paradox. We want to hear about your clan, and drop it down in the comments below for others to take a look at if they do happen to stumble across this video. You know, the core group, that's extremely important. And if the core dies, the clan normally follows behind it. It just falls apart and the clan doesn't exist anymore. And then also, you know, what kind of clan do you want to be? You know, you want to be a pushing clan? Do you want to be competitive? Do you want to get into the esports league? Stuff like that. Just something to think about. And then we talked about recruiting, getting outside of global and going and checking out the community, going into the community servers and taking a look at that stuff. And then we've also discussed of outside communication applications that could be used to, you know, increase or expand your gaming experience within Clash of Clans. And as for Paradox, well, we got some work to do. I got to get with the core group. You know, the guys that have been here for the last year and a half that I've been away, and see what they want to do and how they want to go about it. And we're going to have to come up with a common goal. That's the main thing. Come up with a common goal and build, you know, off of that, what kind of players are looking for, what town hall levels are looking for, maybe build some recruiting posters and stuff like that. Well, you know, you never know. We'll see how it plays out. But anyways, that is going to be about it. Thank you for hanging out with me today, guys. Hopefully the information in this video will help you out quite a bit. It's definitely a different change of pace type video from me. And this is me doing my best to help you suck less. Smash that like button. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. And thanks for watching, guys.
I don't know. I might do a robot. It's coming.
What is it? Dallas, what are you doing, Dallas? Oh!